Welcome to an Amazon S3 on Outposts demo. I'm Mallory Gershenfeld, a senior product manager for S3 on Outposts, and today I will be showing how to use S3 on Outposts for local data processing with an example of how to help improve your operations with computer vision at the edge with AWS Panorama. AWS Panorama is a service that brings computer vision to your on-premise camera network. You install the Panorama appliance or compatible device in your data center, register it, and you can deploy your computer vision applications from the cloud, or in today's session, we'll show how to deploy locally right on your AWS Outpost. Panorama works with your existing real-time streaming protocol network cameras. The appliance runs secure computer vision applications from either AWS partners or that you build yourself with the Panorama application SDK. In a moment, we'll see how Panorama can read and write from the local S3 on Outpost bucket and run a self-contained computer vision application at the edge. We'll see Panorama does inferences on images generated from your video feeds. S3 on Outpost can be used to stage application code, models, and configuration files for deployment to an AWS Panorama appliance. For example, you can receive site safety alerts that monitor off-limit areas at an industrial site. When your Panorama model detects a potentially unsafe situation through an inference image, it can upload the image to your S3 on Outpost bucket and send a notification to Amazon's Simple Notification Service, Amazon SNS, so key recipients can take corrective action. Today, we're going to analyze a sample town center video from the published samples available in GitHub using the AWS Panorama Simulator SDK. Note, we won't use a Panorama device, but it would follow the same deployment path from the device to the outpost. The services we'll use today include AWS Outposts, S3 on Outpost, AWS Panorama, and the Panorama SDK Simulator, and an EC2 instance running on the outpost. Next, we'll go over to the console and bring up our outpost. From the search bar, we'll look for Outposts. And for today's demo, we'll be running this on an outpost ending in 5E. You can manage your S3 on Outpost capacity from the Actions button. So we'll hit Actions, Manage S3 Buckets. For this demo, we have a sample bucket already created that we want to store our model output in. When we click in, a key concept is the Outpost Access Point ARN, which are named network endpoints with a specific access policy that describes how data can be accessed using that endpoint. Access points simplify managing data access at scale for shared data assets in S3 on Outposts. Access point ARNs are required for all object operations on Outposts instead of bucket name. So here we'll click the copy ARN. Next, we're going to launch an instance from EC2 to run our inference simulator. So we'll go back to the AWS Outpost main page, and we see we have 13 instances already running. We'll click into that, and you'll see that'll bring us up to EC2 homepage, and it's filtering to all the instances already running on this outpost. We'll go ahead and search for our demo instance. We'll take note of our IP addresses, and we'll also take note of our key pair name, and make sure that we have it downloaded when we first launch the instance. Second, we'll ensure that EC2 has the correct IAM policy. So we'll go under IAM role and click the SSM role. The two permissions we're looking for are S3 on Outpost full access. So this will enable us to write and read the inference images from the EC2 instance to our S3 on Outpost bucket, and SSM full access so that we can spin up a Jupyter notebook for the model review. Now that we've confirmed our EC2 has the correct permissions, we'll go back to our EC2 management console and we'll connect. To spin up your notebook, we'll use an SSH client. In this case, take note that your PEM key will have to be modified if you're using a tool like PuTTY to be PuTTY-enabled PPK. As mentioned earlier, AWS Panorama has a published GitHub package that we'll be using and a test utility environment that has all the step-by-step instructions on how you will be SSHing and how you will be bringing up your notebook on a particular port of your choosing. Here, we'll use PuTTY for this particular example. And after I've already SSHed in and I'm ready to spin up my notebook, I'll use JupyterLab command. Here, after cloning the GitHub examples, we'll be using the people counter example that's published. you'll see this says People Counter Tutorial Notebook. This notebook has starter code and videos to get you started working with Panorama. We'll install the IDE of our choice, in this case Jupyter, and make sure we have the needed packages in our environment before spinning up the notebook. Here we'll be using the familiar Boto 3 and SageMaker packages in Python, the AWS SDK for Python. It's the same S3 client as in region that you're importing, and here we see we're using the PeopleCounter app. And here we see we'll be using that Town Center video to create the inferenced images from. So we'll import our needed packages. And now that we're ready to test the app and start coding, how are we going to inference the images? You'll see here under categories, we have a variety of classifications, person, bicycle, car, that we're looking for the model to detect in the image and label as such. Next, in this last step, you'll see the send to S3, and you'll see that this is the access point ARN that we copied from the S3 on Outpost console screen. We'll go ahead and run our model. Now we see that the model has successfully run the computer vision model and labeled all the categories that we asked, and it's looping through the pictures. So we see the bench, the person, and the bicycle with the confidence interval that it's been labeled as such. From here, you could package that into an app and deploy it back on your Panorama compliant device. You can store this notebook and all other app files in your S3 and Outpost bucket. So for our final step, we'll go ahead and list the objects that we have just used in the model. So here we're using the same S3 Boto client, and we'll use the list object v2 to list all items in that bucket. And now we see all of the images that we exported from the computer vision model in our local S3 and Outpost bucket using the familiar Boto 3 client. And that concludes our demo. Before Outposts, you've been able to do computer vision models using S3 buckets and region. However, we've heard the customer need to do this locally at the edge for compliance reasons or scenarios where customers are generating a lot of data and want to process and filter locally before sending it back to the cloud for long-term storage. Now, architecting with S3 on Outposts, you can process data locally to support such use cases. Thanks for watching.